Turkcell CEO Kaan Terzioğlu was announced as the winner of GSM Association's Outstanding Contribution to the Mobile Industry Award for 2019 at the Mobile World Congress in Barcelona on February 25. The recognition came as a result of Turkcell's successful incorporation of digital into its business models under Terzioğlu's leadership and the company's focus on using technology for social good and humanitarian development, the company said in a press release. Terzioğlu received the award from GSMA Chairman Stefan Richard during the ceremony attended by Spanish King Felipe VI. It is a privilege to be a part of an industry that can make such a significant difference in the lives of the people it serves and in the well-being of our planet. The evolution of technology empowers us even further, and we, as the mobile operators, need to be at the forefront of this transformation. We will continue to use our technology to the benefit of those who need it the most and who can change their lives with it, and I am confident that we will be in good company of our fellow mobile operators, Terzioğlu said in his acceptance speech. Turkcell's growth and digital transformation in the last 2 years, and their financial results, are testament to Kaan Terzioğlu's foresight, skill and knowledge, Richard said, while presenting the award to Terzioğlu. A special operation unit of the Istanbul Police Department, file photo, Turkish security forces captured 7 high-profile members of the illegal DHKP-C group in a counter-terror operation in Istanbul's Okmeydanı neighborhood early in the morning, Interior Minister Süleyman Soylu said on February 26. One of the detained militants was the most senior operative of the organization in Turkey, state-run Anadolu agency quoted Soylu as saying during a meeting in Istanbul. We have completely overthrown the rural structure of DHKP-C in Turkey, he said. The police raid also captured militants named in the green and gray categories of the Interior Ministry's wanted terrorist list, according to Soylu. Our fight against terrorism is on and will continue without slowing down, he added. The wanted terrorists list is divided into 5 color-coded categories, with red as the most wanted, followed by blue, green, orange and gray. The DHKP-C assumed a number of bloody assaults in Turkey, including a 2013 attack on the U.S. Embassy in Ankara, in which a Turkish security guard was killed. The group is listed as a terrorist organization by Turkey, the U.S., and the EU. A corporate executive heading an international firm's energy department in Turkey has been accused of treating his wife like a sex slave in his harem, according to a petition recently filed at the Istanbul Family Court. The man, identified only with the initials OT, had married his wife, identified only with the initials ST, 31 years ago. The woman's lawyer, Binor Korten Ertek, said in the petition that she demands divorce and compensation because he had relationships with 3 women at work. The defendant has been living for himself. He was behaving as if my client was his slave and concubine. He treated her as if she was one of the concubines in his harem, the petition said. Claiming that OT has a salary of 300,000 Turkish liras as well as 20 million Turkish liras as savings in banks, the woman demands 10 million Turkish liras in compensation. She also wants 30,000 Turkish liras as monthly alimony. The executive is expected to file his defense in the upcoming hearings.